One of the most common questions I get about Bruxzir is how difficult is it to cut off? And as long as you have the right burr, it's really not difficult at all. And so I'm going to cut this Bruxzir crown off that you see right here. This is a Zir-Cut Diamond from Axis Dental. It's a very fine grit diamond, which is a little counterintuitive. You would think you'd need something really coarse to cut through something really tough like zirconia, but that's not true. You need a fine grit. And you can see I lay it against the tooth and then pull it away. Lay it against the tooth and pull it away. Lay it against the tooth, pull it away. Got a lot of water spray going on here. And there's the tooth. You can see the tooth starting to show through. The difference in color between the zirconia and the prep makes it really easy to know when you've cut far enough. So in that respect, it's kind of like cutting off a typical PFM crown. It's not that difficult to see. The shape of the burr here is not that important. I'm using a burr here with a wider tip because it's a supra gingival margin. I go to a tapered, narrow tip burr when I'm really close to the gingiva. And now that I've gone all the way through the buckle and the occlusal, I'm going to take my Christensen crown remover and actually go inside of here. That slot's a little wider than I'd want it to be from that wide diamond, but the wide diamond was more efficient. And boy, you can see I'm really having a crank there, and that distal half comes popping off of there. And that's not only a testament to the strength of the Bruxzir, but to the cement, the Reliex Luting Plus cement from 3MSB that we've used. So the whole mesial half of the crown has not even moved yet, and so we've got to cut through that again because you just can't grab onto that with rheostats and pull that off. So this is one of the difficulties in these all-ceramic crowns as opposed to a PFM is you can't bend the framework, bend the substructure, and then remove the whole thing. When you go to bend it, it breaks and you have to take it off in pieces. So typically we're taking off three, maybe four different pieces of crown, usually four, I would say. So we took off the first one. Now I'm going to crack through the mesial marginal ridge and separate the lingual and buccal portions. And there goes the mesial buccal portion of the crown coming off. And actually, usually you would have to cut this in half one more time. I get lucky here and just push on it, and the vibration from the handpiece has broken the cement bond, so I can actually pull this mesial lingual piece off. Usually you would have to cut that in half again, and then maybe even prep off the last little eighth of crown from the tooth. So again, the key point to remember here is you need to have one of those fine grit Zir-Cut burrs available from Axis Dental. They're also available in the Bruxzir adjustment and polishing kit, so you do not need a separate burr. It's those same burrs that are in the adjustment and polishing kit that cut through zirconia. And as long as you do it with steady pressure off and on, lots of water spray, you'll be fine. You won't see any sparking, and you'll be able to see the differentiation between the crown and the tooth and get the Bruxzir crown off safely. So in this introduction to Bruxzir restorations, I've mentioned my two favorite indications. The first one is when we have limited inner occlusal space on a preparation where we should use cast gold or a metal occlusal, but the patient doesn't like the look of cast gold or metal occlusal. This is a perfect place to put a Bruxzir restoration in place. The second place is anytime I see a broken PFM or any kind of broken porcelain. When I see a patient who's got a strong enough bite to do that kind of damage, I want to go with a virtually unbreakable material like Bruxzir. Bruxzir can also be used for inlays and onlays, so it really can be a cast gold replacement if you want it to be, if your patients don't like cast gold. I happen to like cast gold inlays and onlays better than composite or porcelain, so when patients won't accept those, that's when I move to Bruxzir restorations. On behalf of all of us here at the laboratory, thanks for your time and your continued commitment to quality dentistry.